despite being one of the most influential research institutions, the number one institute for development studies in the world, and claiming to offer a nuanced take on development. Students feel that IDS feeds into an overly simplistic discourse. In the UK, education is becoming a commodity, with tuition fees ever rising, maintenance grants slashed, and with many students off to feel like just another candidate number on a computer database. Stereotypes based on race and nationality are perpetuated by the study of development, with some people feeling as though they are expected to represent an entire group of people. To combat this, the Unruly Politics group wanted to create a space where staff and students can discuss their frustrations with IDS and reveal how they feel they are seen and essentialised by IDS and the education system at large. As a group of around 20 students, they attended the last lecture of the year in costume, parodying the way the school sees them and photobombing the annual IDS picture.
I've had some interesting conversations.
Really?
At IDS, sometimes I feel like I'm just a number because there are so many students this year. This is my candidate number.
Me dressing as a sheep today, in a way, to try and represent how I feel I'm seen by the Institute, but also by the British education system in general and the way that education is going at the moment.
I felt like a Coca-Cola bottle, you know, waiting to be filled in the production line.
But don't you think that being unruly, right, is engaging with politics in a new way?
I feel like I'm just a number, one of the many students that are here.
I feel like sometimes when the students are looked at, it's just like a big crowd and it's indiscernible.
I am one of many sheep, but it felt really, really weird and really uncomfortable to wear this tag, how much money I'm worth. I don't like to talk about money. You can see it in their faces that it makes them uncomfortable how we're just a number, we're just money. And I heard that a fellow, like a senior fellow, also said, like, yes, you're just money.
This represents the countdown to the time the next batch of English students come into IDS.
Studying development and having also worked a little bit in the field, that it's very difficult to get away from the rest of the sheep or get away from the herd even. So I feel like I'm kind of being herded in like one particular direction, and it's all about choosing the right career, the right development organization, getting your foot in the door and all this.
I think one of the reasons that I chose to dress up this way is because when I think about the contribution that I make to education or the academic system, I sometimes feel that my contribution is more based on monetary value rather than on what I can give or what the academic system is doing for me.
This is kind of my way of showing my frustration with the insinuation that I have an ulterior motive for wanting to study gender.
My costume is a clock to represent how we are essentialized as time commitments to the school.
So this is kind of an act of solidarity to show how the pressures work and how they need to justify their existence at the end of every year, the end of every financial year in IDS. And if they do not meet those necessary requisite targets, then they're put on probation. And I think the entire system does not encourage free thinking, especially in higher education. The higher proportion of stuff that they need to do is to get consultancy work rather than be there for us and actually do research.
Well, that's me in a nutshell, an IDS. And like always talking about global north, global south, and kind of very simplistic narratives sometimes, and I feel like alienated.
Sometimes I feel like abandoned. So because I'm not familiar with westernized education system, so I'm not good at English discussion.
Today I'm dressed as African to represent how I feel IDS views me. And this is interesting because IDS is known to have a nuanced view towards development, but I have found that their view of Africa is a bit mainstream, like what every other development institution thinks. Because a couple of times I've sat in lectures, and if someone is sharing about a research in a country in Africa, they will look my direction, or they will look at the direction of the black person in the room.
I mean, just dressing up like this, people, you know, people, you start a conversation, people ask you why you're dressed up like this, and they start to maybe think of it differently.